Welcome to this little vlog here. And how cool is that, having both me and what I'm seeing in the front on the video. And I can even switch this up if you want to. And this is not the topic right now. By the way, this footage is courtesy to the LG Wing that has this feature. But we want to talk about this little bad boy here, which is the Huawei P Smart 2021. And this one I want to tweak a little bit so it is a bit more fluid and usable rather than slow and clunky. So let's take a look at it and let's get started. So here I have my P Smart 2021, and as you can see here, it is running fluid currently, but as soon as I go here, sometimes to this Huawei Assistant feed, it is loading a lot of stuff, and sometimes it gets clunky here because it's loading stuff. So first tip is, if you don't need those things, just remove them, just like shopping. I don't need to know about this shopping thing, so simply remove this. I don't need the weather information here because I have a widget, or could have a widget on my screen. I don't need this. So now it's a lot cleaner already. And you can see I have a weather widget here, so I don't need it a second time. It's a lot cleaner and faster already. What you can do is go to the settings menu at the top, disable the instant access apps here as well. And what it does is, if I go to the feed, you can see that the top row is gone as well. Of course, if you want to have everything disabled, you can also disable the feed, but I like to watch sometimes the news here on my feed, so this is why I have it enabled here. But yeah, this is makes it a lot faster already to have it here, because it doesn't have to load your calendar entries, your weather information, and all the other stuff that it tries to access from the internet. So this makes it already a lot faster in daily usage. The other thing is, just use the power of your chip if you have the battery. As you can see here, eventually I have 100% battery right now. So what I can do is simply go into settings, and under the battery option, I can just simply enable the performance mode. Because if you have the performance mode enabled, it will drain the battery a lot faster. But as you can see here, I have like, usually I have like 47 hours left. And now I have 45 hours left. So it's like 2 hours difference. But you get a much more fluid speed that's not stuttering at all on the device. It's running so smooth, and I can go into apps. I can go here into the web browser. I can go out of the web browser. I can go into Pedal Maps. I can go switch tasks here without any big issues, as you can see here. So it's running a lot smoother already with this performance mode enabled. Of course, it will drain the battery a little bit, but 5000 milliampere hours battery. And it's just so more fluid with this than without this. So I would just recommend you to do it. The other option, more extreme option, if you don't like these animations at all, you can get rid of them at all, completely. Just go into your settings, then you go to accessibility features. I have to see it through the lens here. Accessibility features, and you can go to the top one, which says accessibility, and you have advanced visual effects here. And you can just simply turn this off, and now you have no effects at all. So it's the quickest, because if I go and want to see the list, you can see it's so quick. And even the animations to go back are like instant. All the animations are just simply turned off. And this is, I think, the quickest way possible to have this device running very, very fluid. But if you like the animations like I do, then you don't turn it off. Another option is a bit more tricky option. But what you can do is just go to your settings. And let me just undo what I did before. So go to settings and have advanced visual effects on. And what I will do now is go to About Phone, click 13 times on the build number to be developer, and then you can go into system settings, and then you have here the developer options. And if you use the developer options, you have the ability to just scroll down a bit, scroll down a bit, scroll down a bit. You can see I am definitely watching at my phone through the lens. Scroll down a bit, and here you have animation scale speed, animation scale speed, and you can set it to 0.5 instead of 1, and this also makes every animation a lot faster and a lot smoother. And you might notice a bit more stutter here and there. So what you can do as well is, if you like animation so much, you can also get to 1.5 and 1.5, and now you have very smooth animations. You can see they're a bit slower, definitely, but they are also smoother because the processor has enough time to process the animation, and you can see the animation a lot smoother on the 60 Hz display. So I really like this 1.5 times on this device because it makes things a bit slower, but the device is slow, so why not making the animations a bit slower to have them at least fluid? Otherwise, just turn them off, because otherwise they stutter. And especially with this tweak enabled to have the full speed all the time on, like the performance mode that you can also see at the top there near the battery, as you can see here. There you go. There. If you have this all the time on, this is, I think, the best combination, and yeah, can be your daily driver. And the last but not least best tip, bring myself into frame here, is go to the Optimizer app. Because the Optimizer app, even if it's 98, can optimize your system a little bit more. Close applications and those hungry applications that eat too much RAM. And then your system is super, super fluid. And I think if you have a PSmart 2021, you might never saw this device running so smoothly before. So this is everything for my tips for the PSmart 2021. What do you think about this vlogging style kind of video with the LG Wing? I think it's a pretty nice feature. Should do a little bit about the stabilization of the front cam, because it's not so stable, I would say. Also, it should be a bit more wide angle, and you can show a little bit more of this beautiful device. PSmart 2021 in this green edition, you can see, wonderful device. I also got updates, which is interesting. So it's now on the May, on the May security updates right now, I think. So let's check here. The version is May 2021, as you can see here, eventually there. So May 2021. And yeah, this is a good device, I would say, for 100 euros. Pretty good, awesome device. Anyway, what do you think about those tips and tricks? You can write down in the comment section. That is basically everything for this video. This is everything for this video. I hope you enjoyed this little vlog style. And write down in the comment section if you have such a device and what do you do with such a device. If you have it as daily driver, if it works for you good enough or not. That's everything for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye. Where's the stop button here? Ah, there.